July 3rd, 1905. Dear Andrew, you have just entered a new stage in your life. You have chosen a path that will test to the utmost your sense of responsibility and duty. Please bear with me. I believe, I hope that you're old enough for me to share with you a secret. The secret of what happened to your mother many years ago.
As you were. Come on, clip, clip, snip, snip. Don't be afraid to cut it really close. That's it. There's no such thing as too short. Whose bed is that? That bed is absolutely filthy. It's disgusting. Hey, who said that you could hang pictures of your dames in here? Huh? Who hung this girl's picture?
It's Mozart.
Who?
It's Mozart, sir.
Mozart! Which one of you is Mozart? Mozart, front and center!
He's dead, sir.
He died? When? Company! Front and center now! He died! Why didn't somebody report this to me? Why wasn't this reported to me?
I don't know, sir.
Why didn't somebody tell me about this?
I don't know anybody here yet, sir.
Mozart was a great composer, sir. He died many years ago.
Company! Report to the parade ground! Call in 2 minutes! Full field equipment, including your masks! Double charge! Move it! Move it!
I bet you smart Alex thought I didn't know who Mozart was.
Yeah, sure I know.
Well, I don't give a shit about Mozart. You, repeat after me. I don't give a shit about Mozart.
I don't give a shit about Mozart, sir.
Good. Take off your mask. Now, if you want to take off those nasty masks, repeat after me. I don't give a shit about Mozart.
I don't give a shit about Mozart, sir.
Good. Take them off.
Nice hairdo, but I don't hear you.
I can't say it. Mozart is a great composer, sir.
Oh. So, you girls think you can take on Sergeant Mad Dog O'Leary?
Why do you say that? He's a dead man.
Okay. Wanna play games? Let's see who wins.
It's not my fault he's a great composer.
The story I'd like to tell you began before you were born. Your mother had left her native Chicago and was traveling to Russia. She was on a train bound for Moscow on very delicate business.
Ставлю рубль, господа, наверняка есть свободный купе.
Господа,
ну, началось. Господа, вперед!
Господа, императора, господа!
Вернитесь, вы куда, господа?
За что-то?
О, господи, папа. Excuse me, madam, I don't want to bother you.
Попасть, куда же эти все запропастились?
Just what do you think you're doing?
Thank you, madam.
Security, ma'am. We're bodyguards.
Oh.
An elite unit. We've been sent to Petrenko. There's a maniac on the train. A head chopper.
Oh.
A terrorist.
His accomplice is black.
I've seen him.
You have?
Really?
Really?
He's a short African prince.
That's his government.
All his victims are foreign women.
Foreign women traveling alone.
Widows, too.
Especially foreign widows traveling alone.
Oh, how terrible. But I have a secret weapon.
Oh, really?
Really?
Please, show us.
Please.
Please.
Excuse us, Cadet Tolstoi.
Yeah,
you'll be guarding the lady. You'll be in good hands with the Grand Duke's cadet, man.
Si lui convient de refuser.
Tu la kiffes.
I don't want to trouble you. I'm a cadet. His Highness the Grand Duke Alexei Alexandrovich is patron of our Imperial Military School.
Sit down.
Thank you. And I'm going to be an officer.
What are those?
Oh, these. These are... Bubliki.
They look good. May I?
Of course. Sorry, I didn't introduce myself. Andrei Tolstoi, to your service.
Tolstoi? Tolstoi?
No, sorry. No relation.
Jane. Callahan. Have you read Anna Karenina?
Not all of it.
Yeah.
Sorry. Right away.
Don't worry. Yes, fix it.
Да, господа, я бы на ней не женился, это точно.
Господа, а что она заблажила-то?
А бог ее знает.
От восторга.
От восторга?
От восторга.
Why did your friends take off like that? Russians don't like opera.
On the contrary, we have an amateur opera company at our school.
Does the Grand Duke sing too?
No. But he comes to the performances.
Oh, how lovely. Did you sing?
Yes. We're rehearsing Mozart opera, The Marriage of Figaro.
Oh. What part did you play?
Figaro? The Barber of Seville.
Oh, please. Sing something.
Now.
Yes, please.
Right now. Non più dai farfarone amoroso. Girando delle belle, turbando il riposo.
Ma c'è un muscoli d'attudo.
Delle belle, turbando.
А кто первый ушел?
Ну я ушел. Ну а что, ну вы же тоже.
Браво!
Пошутили. Сейчас бы ехали в вагоне первого класса. Вместе с Толстым.
Would you like a glass of champagne?
I...
to Mozart.
To Mozart? You won't get into trouble.
Not at all.
Позвольте, позвольте. Господин капитан! Господин капитан!
To Anna Karenina. Sorry. Madam! After you've eaten in public, do you know what's left? The hole. The hole's left. It's a joke. О, господа, по-моему, там серьезно.
Возбудились, не война.
Если натоптались.
Пардон,
господин капитан, что случилось?
Все в порядке.
I'll fix it. I enrolled in military school, so my mother would be proud of me. This is my
mama.
She's an actress. Isn't she beautiful? Извините. И шампейн left. Come in. Мадам, Tolstoi.
Господин капитан!
Что?
Would you care for a glass of champagne?
Стой!
Сюда вперед.
Вперед.
Stand up when you speak to your commander!
Madam, please excuse us.
Get him out, его отсюда! Слушайте, слушайте!
It's been a pleasure to make you acquaintance, madam.
For me too, Cadet Tolstoi in military school.
There's been no military school,
madam! Sorry, madam.
Sorry, madam.
Excuse us, madam. Welcome to Russia.
Oh! Your mother thought herself a woman of experience, wise to the ways of the world. But despite her age, none of life's lessons had taught her to reckon with Russia. She knew that Russia had a czar, caviar, vodka, bears, and somewhere in Moscow, a particular Grand Duke who was of great interest to her because of the business which brought her there.
Douglas, calm down!
We're out of money. The workers stopped in my machine.
They fired me.
You're a drunk. You promised to get me the money from the technical committee.
Don't be so nervous.
Jane is my last hope. My machine. And Jane will help me. Jane will get me the money. What if she doesn't show up?
Father?
Jane.
My luggage, it's in the third compartment.
Третий купе.
Oh, Father, you've grown so old.
Me?
And you are?
Well, yes. Kopnovsky.
Kopnovsky. Mr. Kopnovsky, there are six bags. Kopnovsky.
Six?
Kopnovsky.
Six pieces. And how is your husband, Harry?
Larry? He died. Oh. Don't you remember? I wrote you, Father. He was eaten by crocodiles when we jumped into the Nile, fleeing the siege of Khartoum. I swam faster, but it was quite gruesome. Only his bow tie was left.
And then, yes, you went to live in Persia.
India.
Наши едут. Пострель. Хорошо.
Sonny. What's that?
That's cadets. And General Radlov. That bald idiot took my job. He has cold spaghetti instead of brains. Sit down.
Что тут делает господин генерал?
Тебя пьяного пришел посмотреть. Ай-яй-яй. Анна Каренина споила Толстого.
Ребятки! Я счастлив!
Дали!
Radlov's our man. He's got great influence with the Grand Duke. He's vice chair of His Majesty's Technical Engineering Committee.
Это без ни шагу! Марш!
Фуражка, милая, не вбейся!
Мистер Кабновский, did you imply that the general is bald? Looks to me like he has a lot of hair.
He not only takes other people's jobs, he wears other people's hair.
What we need is to get other people's money. Money for my machine.
The Kremlin.
Sort of brighter, cleaner version of the mosques in Turkey. What's that?
Не делайте этого.
Как?
Я не буду больше.
Зачем вы?
Пожалуйста. Спасибо.
Как?
Всех
поймали! Все поймали! Все поймали! Отдай скрыши!
Андрей! Всех! Всех!
Мы там! Что с вами? Построение!
Come on, let's not take all day! Behind your ears. Remember, without soap, there is no hope. Pick her up. Got it.
I've had it. You must be dying in there. Are you okay?
To tell the truth, I'm not doing very well.
I don't give a shit about Mozart. I can't hear you.
Why don't you just say it? I can't. Mozart is a great composer.
Bitter, cold, and violent explosions, she need never have left Chicago. Jane had been led to expect a more sedate arrival by her English-speaking, cultured young cadet. Moscow was full of surprises. The biggest surprise, however, lay unfinished in McCracken's workshop.
Look, there it is. My dream. My life. My love. My idol. Look. 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 She has never moved, but she is full of life. Look at her body. I have christened her.
She has a name.
The Barber of Siberia. She is sleeping, but when she awakens, we will hear her all the way to Siberia. I know she's not working yet, but... Watch your feet! Do you know what my baby can do? One day, it can cut down more trees than 500 men can cut down in 1 month. And I'm gonna harvest all those trees from here to the Pacific. Chop, 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 clip, 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 chop, chop, clip, 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 chop, chop, clip, clip, chop, chop, clip, clip, chop, chop, clip, 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 chop, chop, clip. The Barber.
The Barber of Siberia.
You get it?
Listen. Can you hear her?
Hear her music? Can you hear her singing to me?
But you're making that noise.
Of course it's me. Oh, of course it's me making that noise. For God's sake, it is hardly you. Some nights, when I'm lying in my bath, I can hear her singing to me, her poetry, her music, songs. I'll wake you up one night, and you will hear it too. Oh, you'll hear the songs, the whispers, the music. Oh, I'm wasting time. We've got work to do. Come, Novsky! Come, come! We have work to do! Come!
Yeah, Novsky, stop! More calls in the room. Oh, so, you are a genius. We don't even have money to fix the road.
You don't have money because you were fired from the engineering committee for being drunk?
I was fired because I'm not German.
Fired.
Yes, okay. It moves, but it...
You promised it would fly! It would fly.
It will. If I say so, it will.
Yes, if you say so. My baby needs work, but it needs money to finish the job. So we've got to get the subsidy from the gradual.
Yeah. Hmm? Fine. Completely crazy. Life had taught Jane not to ignore chance occurrences. She already knew her first move.
Yeah.
барышни. Давайте-ка лучше повторим спряжение.
Je pars tout ensemble.
Seront les dames et les numéros 2 seront les messieurs. Alors, messieurs, de la tenue, s'il vous plaît, de la tenue. Alors.
Хорош Толстой. Он с Анной Карениной в поезде шампанское распивал. Она маэстро влепили.
На притч... Как нужно... Шампанское хватит уже! Я вас, граф, между прочим, тоже пьяным таскал.
Когда?
Ну, вот так вот.
А, ну да.
Is this the right address?
Yes, it's military school.
General Radlov?
Yes. Пропустите.
Спасибо.
От Маринина.
Добрый день. Where will I find General Radlov?
General Radlov? Второй этаж, мадам.
Second floor. Third floor.
First floor.
Ground floor.
Спасибо.
Next floor. Third floor. Last floor.
Не училище, а засад какой-то. То аистом стоишь, то раком ползаешь. Что это за мастик такая вонючая? Сюр, сюрприз. Специаль пур лебаль де гранд эколь. Мастик и сюрприз развеселит вас на весь оставшийся вечер.
Нас она уже с утра веселит. Это точно.
Ваш приз к вам дама?
Дама? А кто такая?
Иноземная подданная.
Оп-оп-оп. Проси.
Прошу, мадам.
Hello.
Bonjour, madame.
You broke your music box.
Please. Parlez-vous français?
Non.
Sprechen Sie Deutsch?
Nein.
English. Excuse me, my English is not good.
I'm sure it's better than my Russian.
Английский словарик мне быстро. Let me introduce myself.
I know who you are. Baron von Radlov.
Yes.
Lieutenant General, Director of the Imperial Military School, Vice Chairman of His Imperial Majesty's Committee on Engineering and Technical Inventions.
Yes.
It's very impressive. Very. I'm simply Jane Callahan. Mind if I smoke?
Please.
Jane McCraken Callahan.
Oh, McCraken?
Yes, yes, the mad inventor. Mm. He's my father.
Mm.
He's obsessed with his machine. Oh. Please, please, let's not talk about it. You have a wonderful collection of books.
Потише, потише, извинитесь.
Have you read them all?
Mm.
Oh, look, you have...
Shh, shh, shh. private line. To the Grand Duke.
The Grand Duke.
Yes.
Grand Duke.
Right.
Oh, is that him?
So, I happen by chance to find myself in the same train compartment as one of your cadets. Well, he left this photograph on the seat. His name is the same as the famous writer, Tolstoi.
Oh, yes, of course. I'll take care of it.
I thought this photograph might be dear to him. My husband was a military man. I'm a widow. He died in combat.
Widow.
Captain O'Reilly Fitzpatrick McNamara Callahan. He died with Custer at the Battle of Little Bighorn. I have to say, it is an honor to be the widow of such a man. I don't know why I'm telling you all this. You're a very sensitive man, General. Maybe it's just that you have such an extraordinary face. You definitely remind me of someone. Alexander, perhaps.
Our Tsar?
No, Alexander the Great of Macedonia.
Oh.
He also had a shock of wild hair.
Извините.
Наряд аиста второй роты заканчивает снятие купола.
Вам, дорогая, наш доверием пришла.
Что происходит?
Так...
Ваше превосходительство, готовим помещение к балу.
Вам было приказано полы натирать.
Ну, так...
Ваше превосходительство, так мы их уже...
Продолжайте натирать полы.
Слушаюсь!
Did I hear him mention a ball?
Yes. The school's annual ball. We would be most pleased to have your aunt as our guest.
Thank you, General. My father and I'll be honored to attend.
Cadet Tolstoi?
Yeah!
Come here.
Pardon, madame. Ваш присутствие к аппарату.
Excuse me?
You've probably come for a fan.
Oh.
I haven't been able to have it fixed yet. We were punished.
Punished? Because of me?
No.
You know, you're better at waxing floors than you were at drinking. You even forgot your photograph. I have it here.
Thank you very much. I was looking for it.
Excuse me? What did you say? Say it again.
Передайте графине, бал состоится непременно.
Как всегда.
Нашел, что я просил. Как всегда.
Генерал идет! 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 Генерал идет!
Что происходит, господа?
Ваше происходительство. Наряд наказанных аистов продолжает натирку паркета.
Ах, да. Продолжайте. Excuse me, the count is about the ball.
Ваше присутствие?
Да?
Я его нашел.
Кого?
Александра Македонского, вы просили.
Alexander the Great of Macedonia. What did I tell you? Same face. I have to go.
Маменька.
Что? Господи, боже мой. Андрей, а почему он дома? Это значит, что случилось?
Нет.
Так
добрый день, Николя.
Я знаю.
Ничего нет?
Да,
не случилось?
Да, знаю.
Просто я буквально подальше минут дверь отпросился из училища.
Ну, значит, что случилось?
Ничего не случилось.
А что, в чем дело? Ну, и так с глазу на глаз. Я не понимаю, какие могут быть секреты. А где он, кстати? А, да, вот это Николя. Говори, пожалуйста, побыстрее, потому что я опаздываю на поезд. Я в Варшаве играю леди Макбет, но тебя, по всей вероятности, это не интересует.
Это очень интересует.
Ты положила тайну.
Маменька, меня это очень интересует. Дело в том, что мне надо было денег немного. Всего 3 рубля.
Тайну? Как вы держите тайну? Я же не могу дробить тайну. Вот она.
Да.
Значит, ты говоришь, всего 3 рубля. Да? Вот, Николя, я вам только что говорила.
Чаю принести?
Кому мы уже пили?
Нет, спасибо.
Что молодое поколение совершенно... Ой, господи, господи. Да молодое поколение совершенно... А где мой этот сам мундштук?
Вот мундштук.
Да. Молодое поколение совершенно... Вот ты носишь спички, значит, ты куришь.
Маменька, я не курю. Я не курю.
Молодец. А скажи мне, Андрей, скажи, мой друг, ты никогда не задумывался, как непроста моя жизнь.
Маменька, мне надо это все 3 рубля.
Вот из-за этого человека я пожертвовала своей карьерой. Я отвергла такое...
Вы сидели в пути, маменька?
Да, да. Такое чекое. А где вот это, вот, которое я пью, когда мне... Господи, я отвергла. Вот все-таки, Андрей, я бы хотела... А никого нет. Кому я это говорю? Я не понимаю. Никого нет. Ни здравствуйте, ни до свидания, ни слова.
Все-таки я думаю, что эффект не был бы вот так.
3 рубля. Нет, ты сейчас сиди.
Это Николь, а?
Надя.
Да ты что?
3 рубля.
Ты
а
что,
потом
Андрей?
Вернете.
Да, ну, Господи.
Берите, а потом вернете. Берите, берите.
Спасибо, я верну, я прям верну. Ну, ты понимаешь, ну я же вещь чужую поломал, мне надо мне ее починить. Ну, спасибо, а.
Я правда верну.
Supposed to have organized this ball. My girls seem to be doing all the entertaining.
Лизонька, у вас ленточка развязалась.
Ой, спасибо, Машенька. Ой!
My supply sergeant doesn't read French well. I bought a carton of French wax for practical jokes. It's called surprise.
Oh.
Do something immediately.
Mais pourquoi l'orchestre ne joue pas?
Excellence, les invités refusent de danser.
Oh my God!
C'est dangereux.
Oh my God! Vous сделаете же что-нибудь.
Mrs. Callahan.
Where is Winner? What is Winner?
Maître, quelqu'un a volé notre
colophon.
Envoyez quelqu'un chercher de la colophon.
C'est déjà fait.
Oh, Kitty. Oh, Kitty, my precious one. Catch it.
Excuse us, Mrs. Callahan. My supply sergeant, stupid.
Thank you so much for inviting us. I love your country.
Right.
Господа, мы долго еще.
Кити, иди сюда, моя собачка хорошая. Кити.
Господа, бархоточка. Патрулей. Толстой, погуще, погуще, машьте, я тяжелый.
Меня отец всегда канифоль с собой на охоту брал.
Готов.
Чтоб за бокой стрельни не впискальцы получили.
Кити, послужи отечеству, Кити.
Ребята, заканчивайте.
Маме не слово.
Кити, где моя Кити?
Ой, духами пахнет. Ну что, готовы?
Толстой, вперед, Анна Каренина замерзла без танца.
Ой, Патрулей, да хватит нюхать там наверху.
Все живые.
Толстой, вы что?
А вы что,
шансы? Ничего. И что? Господин Терра. Жизнь! Сирна!
Далее.
Фу! Шагов.
Джек, they put resin on the soles of the shoes.
Oh, my precious Kitty.
Канифоль.
It's your mama.
Countess, your Kitty.
Thank you, dear. Wonderful boys! You came to my rescue when your general could not
help. Excuse me.
Now we can have dancing!
Oh. Mesdames et messieurs, préparez-vous pour la marche! Messieurs, invitez les dames! Maestro!
La danse!
Господин Гран, и мне, и мне. Готово?
Тогда что?
И раз.
Раз, два.
Повернулись. И раз.
Раз, два.
Прошу вас, быстренько, парни. Потом, потом, вечером.
Выступаем, господа!
господа, проверки своих давнишних сомнений по поводу прогрессивности корсетов. И обнаруживаю, что оного на ней нет.
Как?
Более того, и лифа заметить не могу. Зато потом, под лопаткой левой, нахожу маленькую-маленькую родинку. Толстой! Толстой! А вы нам ничего не хотите сказать по поводу родины?
Граф.
Вам ее в поезде не показывали?
I must ask you to stop.
А что вы все время asking me to, Толстой? You behave as if you have some kind of claim on this American woman.
Действительно.
So you sang for her once when you were drunk, and we all had to stand the stork because of you.
Ну, в самом деле.
And you're telling me we can't talk about it?
So.
Yes. With the tips of my fingers, I touch this little mole ever so lightly. Mm-hmm. And suddenly, I feel my lady arch her back.
Постойте, Арч. Арчпать! А, изгибается.
Изгибается, and shivers run through her body. Господа, я не могу рассказывать, видя это лицо. Продолжение рассказа позже, после того, как уснет Толстой. Андрей!
Подлородил юнкер Толстой, уволенный со двора, явился без замечаний и происшествий.
Идите.
Слушаюсь.
Давай.
Юнкер Полиевский, уволенный со двора, явился без замечаний и происшествий.
Вольно. Проводили?
Так точно.
Идите.
Слушаюсь. Андрей, ты что, действительно обиделся?
Граф, я не имею вашего титула и опыта. И говорить в том тоне о женщине, в котором вы только что позволили говорить себя мисс Каллиган, непозволительно.
Андрей. Что ты в самом деле? Что я такого сказал? Вы бы тоже могли что-нибудь об этой дюймовочке рассказать, которая так отплясывает. Честь имею, граф. Толстой, вы что, серьезно?
Совершенно.
Раз, два, три, четыре, пять, шесть, семь, восемь, девять.
11, 12,
13, 14, 15. Подай, игра!
Good morning! Sit down, sweethearts!
Господа, игра! I didn't do it, Your Honor.
Sit down.
Господа, игра!
Can you talk slowly?
Yeah.
Perhaps you will come up and show us on the map. Where Napoleon ended his eventful life.
The island of St. Helena. Is
here.
No, sweetheart, that is not the island of St. Helena.
I prepared today's lesson, but that question wasn't in it.
Do you think the enemy cares what lesson you prepared for today? Now, which one of you sweethearts can show us where Napoleon died?
I can, Your Honor.
Oh.
This little mole on the tender back of the ocean is the island of St. Helena. And what Cadet Tolstoy showed us is just fly droppings.
But it wasn't a sign.
Silence! Cadet Polayevsky.
Yeah?
You will no doubt do quite well in the examination. You may sit down. But be careful.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Cadet Tolstoy.
Yeah?
You will no doubt fail the examination, and you will also, Cadet Tolstoi, report to your company commander that you have the honor to rule 2 hours. Stock standing?
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you. God bless you, Your Honor.
3 hours. Stock standing.
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you.
Silence!
Граф, вы низкий человек. Я к вашим услугам.
О, вот как. Что же, на дворе есть 2 старые пушки. На них и будем драться.
Толстой, через час репетиции.
Хорошо, хорошо. Может быть, училище наконец взорвем.
Я не шучу.
Толстой, вы вообще понимаете, чем это нам грозит, ежели узнают о дуэли?
На рассвете в гимнастической зале. Выбирайте оружие.
Предоставляю это право вам.
Эскадроны.
Толстой, не рискуйте, я же лучше фехтую.
Вот там и проверим. 4 часа по полуночи, гимнастическая зала, эскадроны. Честь имею.
Честь имею.
Только не проспите.
Ладно тебе, Толстой. Опусти ногу-то. Отдохни. Я никому не скажу. Ну, не хотите, как хотите. Смена!
My dearest boy, every night I pray that God shares with you his wisdom. I pray that you avoid the kind of youthful error committed by the Russian cadets 20 years ago. Your mother tried to unravel the mysteries of this huge and incomprehensible country. In Russia, you can steal or cheat, but your word is worth more than any official piece of paper with a wax seal. And a word carelessly chosen can lead to bloodshed.
Оттачивают уже, ваше посредство. Днем времени хватает.
Павел Тимофеевич.
Николай Карлович.
Балван! Фехтов? Продолжайте.
Ты бы еще государя разбудил, болван!
Ну, Мухин, оттачиваю туше.
Я 10 лет в Туркестане солдатом, благодарите Бога, и за помощь никакой дуэли не было. А была глупость. Глупость парень, репетовка фигуров. Шутка, черт вас, полили на дуэль. Запомнили?
Да,
марш спать.
А, эспадрон.
Давай сюда, мушкетеры хрена.
Что будет? Что будет?
There are times in life when laws of the heart stand above written laws, even in the military. Fortunately, Andre's wound was not serious. Captain Mokin risked his career, violating school regulations by not informing his superiors. And no one learned about the duel. Not even Jane. Not knowing of the havoc she had inadvertently caused, Jane was getting closer to a goal, though she was unaware of the challenges that lay ahead.
What does Kopnotsky do at your house?
He helps my father with his machine.
Kopnotsky?
Mm-hmm.
But he drinks like a horse.
We say like a fish.
Ah, yes, thank you. Like a fish.
I thought everyone in this country drank. Don't you?
Yeah, not. No.
Never?
I hate drinking.
Where are we going?
I want to introduce you to my mother. She'll be 90 this year.
90?
Yes, 90.
What's that?
It's a muslins.
Muslins?
It's a pancake fair.
Pancake fair?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Tomorrow is the last day of festivities. Kuzma, поворачивай на я. The Sunday of forgiveness.
Forgiveness for what?
For everything. It's an old Russian tradition.
Old Russian tradition.
Yes. And the day after tomorrow, Lent begins.
Lent.
Yes. Veliki Post.
Veliki Post.
Yes.
Veliki Post. Look at the poles.
Oh.
They're beautiful. Look. Look at that.
Petrushka.
Look at that.
Russian clown.
Look at the gypsies.
Oh, Russian clown. Many gypsies.
The bear! Oh my God!
It's a national pastime, drinking vodka.
Whoa,
I told you, in Russia, animals drink like people, and people drink like animals.
Where are they? Where are they going?
To the river, from the fist fight.
Fist fight?
It's an old Russian tradition.
Old Russian tradition.
Russian bread. Yes?
Sushka.
A little... No, no. A little public
sushka. Sushka?
Yes.
Oh, my.
И красный, и черный.
Пожалуйста.
Блины.
Блины.
Yes.
Блины.
Выйдите! Все!
Хорошо.
Gracias.
Наливай, наливай.
Please.
Please.
No. No, no.
Oh,
no.
I can't believe it. An army man who doesn't know how to drink.
Yeah, Jane,
yeah,
but
I know,
no.
I know.
If I drink, no.
Come on,
no,
I want you to drink my health. Come on. Be an animal.
Smirnov, hold me.
Yes! Yes.
Желание мое оставить училище, не окончив слушание его полного курса.
Да вы что, господин юнкер? Пиши.
Я такого писать не буду.
Чего? Нашли блески,
нет? Какой блески? Иди сюда! Вон, смотри!
Запой.
Запой! Запой!
Запой, запой. Драки какие-то.
Запой!
Запой!
Господа Анкера, минуточку, подожди! Ах, Юнкера.
Where's the bear? I want to fight! Ой!
Calm down. He's fine.
Yes, he doesn't like
vodka. Thanks. You don't have to drink that. All right. Time to go home. He's very thirsty. Very thirsty. Cold. All right. Time to go. Thirsty man. All right. Don't eat that. That's the glass. Spit it out. Children are watching you. The general's really drunk.
Водка!
Выпился! Вот водка! Выпил!
А фуражка? Фуражка как у нее найдет? Так, вот так,
фуражка. Да.
Потемкин, теперь еще ты мой.
Нет, ваше величество, война еще не кончилась.
Ах, это варварский народ. Ах, это племя не образованное. Адитон, пленного Потемкина ранить.
Да понял.
Попадание врач.
Так. Наполеон! С островом бежал! По льду! Держись!
Держись!
Так. Я его государь доставлю! Живьем!
Ваше
Мерсенце!
Стойте, Ваше Мерсенце!
Ура! Ура! Куда деть, Ваше Мерсенце? Держись! Потемкин!
Я не могу!
Обереги!
Какой государь?
Молчи! Денег дам!
Простите меня, Христа ради.
За что?
Так ведь прощенное воскресенье нынче.
Бог простит, простите меня, грешник. Ты кто?
Как кто? Наполеон. Вы разве не знаете?
Где я?
В России, ваше превосходительство.
Добрым утром. И с праздником.
С праздничком.
Господи, проси мою душу, хлеб.
The last day of Pancake Week is the Sunday of forgiveness. Forgiveness is sought freely between family and friends, strangers and foreigners. Thus the soul is relieved of remorse and resentment. Of course, in this extraordinary country, everything is taken to its extreme. Half-naked men on the frozen river beat each other black and blue, then beg each other for forgiveness. They go off to war singing, to a wedding in tears. And everything is serious. Every last thing.
How could you do this to me? Who knows? When we'll meet Radlov now? I haven't got a day to spare. I haven't got a dime to spare. I mean, what will happen now? Do you know what Zapoy means? It means drunk.
Oh, Oleksiy, come in. Come in. My God, what happened?
Oh, it's an old Russian tradition. Huh. Forgive me, for the love of Christ.
For what?
Today is holiday, and you're supposed to answer, God will forgive you. По-русски, Бог простит.
Бог простит.
Да, Бог простит.
Бог простит.
I have to talk to you.
All right. Silly boys, dueling over nothing. You could actually have killed each other.
We could have.
So why'd you get yourself into that fist fight?
Huh? это... I don't know. Maybe I was ashamed. Okay, shall I tell you the truth? I wanted the envy knocked out of me.
What envy?
Ordinary Russian envy.
Ah, why is Russian envy special?
Oh, madam. Russian envy, it drives the country. Like the steam engine in Britain. I saw how it looks at you, how it gets nervous, jealous, and how it tries to cover it. How you look at him.
Captain Mokin's on duty today, so I think you have 10 minutes. Please, help us. Don't let him quit school. Sorry, sorry, but I have to go. Don't let him quit school.
Ангела за трапезой, господин Кира.
Спасибо.
Visit a sick friend. Can I use these?
Of course.
Is that your medicine?
Yes.
Does that say Tolstoi?
Oh, Tolstoi.
Tolstoi. You're the only one here. Everybody else got well.
Hmm?
What happened to you?
Nothing. Nothing serious. In fencing class. But how did you know?
Blinis.
Blinis.
What are they treating you with?
Oh, I guess. They give me medicine, they change my bandages. That's my letter!
Oh, I'm sorry. What letter?
My letter of resignation.
Oh. Who's it to?
General Radlov.
Oh. I'm afraid you won't see him for a long time.
Why?
He's on Zapoy.
What?
Zapoy, did I get it right?
Zapoy.
He's on a drunk. You know what a Zapoy is.
Zapoy, I know, but how do you?
I saw it myself.
Jane. Bing.
Andrei, sometimes we think we're taking revenge on life. But it turns out we're only taking revenge on ourselves. I have to go.
promise me that you won't fence without a fencing jacket? And promise me that you won't quit your school. Oh.
Three. Old Russian tradition.
Yes. I'll pick up those later.
Jane. Do you have them all on your back?
What did you say?
Nothing. Forgive me.
Бог простит. Eat your dinner. Bon appetit.
Bye.
You have extraordinary friends. Bye.
Я видел. Это глаза так не курались, албай. Квартального к стулу привязал.
Помню.
Медведем травил. Не помню.
Нет.
А мячик у слона в цирке отобрал. Мамка меня в детстве уронила. Вот что это.
Все.
Прорубь. Пошел.
Слава тебе, Господи, я в стиле.
О, залетный я.
Все горит, все горит.
Спасибо. Дурата, дурата. Ну даже. Отдай. Еще один. Отдай, Кузьма. Ой, прости, прости. Кузьма, прости меня. Лиля. Варю. Варю, давай.
Поехали.
Давай, Варю. Пошел, залетный.
The endless Moscow winter eventually turned to spring. The long-awaited day had come for the 2nd Unit cadets to be sworn in as officers.
Я тут, господа.
Искра!
Здравствуй, братец. Ну, давай посмотрим твоих. Какие пузо ты себе отъел, генерал, а?
Ваши братцы.
Да-да-да. Поехали смотреть на той неделе.
Мы готовы, Ваше Величество.
How many times do I have to tell you?
What?
Misha is too young for all this. He gets excited when people shout.
Marsh!
Why don't you ever listen to me?
If I'd listened to you, my lady, we wouldn't have children at all.
Офицеры, запомните, стать под пулю не задача. Храбрость – это терпение, терпение в опасности, это победа. Русский солдат храбр, стоек и терпелив, потому непобедим. Любите русского солдата. Берегите его. Счастья вам, юнкера. Ура!
Oh!
Ваше предсказательство.
Отставить, вы куда идешь?
Нет, тут песня.
Садись!
Ваше предсказательство, я не...
Садись! Пошел! Пошел! Беда. Свататься еду. Просить руки и сердце. Не правда ли странно? Глупость.
Скажите, я вас поздравляю.
Юнкер, годы, вам это не понять. Юнкер, по-мужски, помогите. Вы же знаете мой английский. Помогите. Останови. Я тут выписал кое-что из поэтов. Ну что с вами, Юнкер? Когда еще придется генерала сватать? Вперед! Вперед!
Oh, Dan.
General.
Excuse me. Nice to see you.
How beautiful. Thank you. Pelina. Wonderful. Find a vase. What are you?
I didn't know. I was on my way to return your fan.
Oh! Let me introduce one of my cadets, Andrei Tolstoi, no relation to the writer. We're capable, young man.
Yes, General. The cadet and I have met. You introduced him to me?
I did. How wonderful. How wonderful. Come, General. Come. Please. I want you to feel it. Come. Sit. Oh, so, the weather is fine today. I love the spring in Moscow. Have you looked into the matter of my machine?
Yes.
And the resolution could possibly be favorable?
Yes.
Thank you.
And you will put in a word with the Grand Duke?
Yes.
Please, sit down.
Oh!
An invitation to a school opera?
The marriage of Figaro? Will the Grand Duke attend?
Yes.
Andrew, are you going to be singing?
Yes.
Sit down.
My father, he died. My mother.
She didn't. She's 90.
Yes. Сынок, прочти как следует.
My whole life depends on the decision for which I have come to this house.
Yes.
The poet says, love is like the measles. You only have it once, and the later in life it happens, the worse it is. Another poet says, all ages are under love's sway. Or it's also said, all's fair in love and war. I have been in war, and now I'm in love for the first time in my life. I fell in love with you at first sight. I loved you when first I saw you. There, in the train compartment.
What train compartment?
And I will never love anyone more, because I will never be able to love anyone else. In a few months, I'll become an officer. It's true. To start, my salary will be low and our family is poor. Of course, I have no right to start a family. But if I could hope, have even the smallest hope of winning your hand and heart in the future,
I would be happy. Forgive me.
And may I be excused.
Go. I met the young man on the train, and he sat on my fan, and undertook to have it repaired for me. And today, as I understand, he wanted to return this fan to me. But he behaved so ridiculously, so strangely.
Excuse me. With your permission, I pay you a visit some other time. O'clock.
Please call anytime.
Doing such a great job. I should have seen it coming. My whole life. My life's work. For a stupid boy.
All right, enough. I've had it with that machine. You need that machine, you'll get it. You'll get everything according to our contract. And don't shout at me. Don't you think you are? My husband, my brother, my father. You do you at least understand what that boy did here today? What he's done to himself.
На знаменку! Гоняй, грэн, копай!
Что с прической завтра будем делать?
Вот твой комфорт.
Что?
Нету.
Возьми все, нету.
Вот он! Вот он.
Фигаро, ваше превосходительство.
Строй!
Слушай!
Знаете ли вы, кто стоит перед вами? Унтер-офицер Толстой? Нет, это уже... лжец, настоящий обманщик. Последний вор не сделал бы того, что сделал он. Выманить у дамы иноземной подданной дорогую вещь под предлогом ремонта. Последний Фендрик постыдился бы, а унтер-офицер Толстой не постыдился. Сделал это. Мальчишка, жизни!
Captain Mokin told Jane that he had never seen General Radlov so infuriated. He persuaded the general to postpone Tolstoy's punishment because it was the only cadet who could sing Figaro the next day. The Grand Duke had been invited to the performance, and cancellation would mean taking the scandal beyond the walls of the school. Tolstoy was even allowed his usual leave before a performance, along with the other cadets.
Unbelievable. It's got guts. I don't know. Mad dog O'Leary losing sleep over a bunch of songs. I really don't give a shit about this Mozart. I really don't.
Дуняша!
Бегу! Да кто ж?
Дуняша!
Андрей Алексеевич, еще там?
Дуняша, я деньги твои 3 рубля пропутил. Копил, копил, и брат. Путил, так на. Не ругайся, ладно, Дуняша, я прошу, не ругайся. Потому что все, все кончено.
Андрей Алексеевич.
Что тебе, Дуняша?
Вас там ждут.
Кто? Маменька приехали?
Нет.
А кто?
Aren't you glad to see me? Why are you looking at me like that? This is my real hair. Do you have anything to eat? Anything? I don't know. It seems strange. I'd like something to eat.
I don't know. I'll ask. Дуняша!
А?
У нас поесть что-нибудь найдется?
Да, телятины могу подать, холодный, грибов.
Сколько там здесь?
Давно.
Молодец. Ты попить что-нибудь, ладно?
She'll serve something now, but it's whatever there is.
Do you live here with your parents?
Just my mother and Dunyasha. Father died.
Oh, I'm sorry.
My uncle Nicola stays here sometimes. Dada!
Вот чем богаты. Мы гостей не ждали.
Спасибо, Дуняша.
I have something important to tell you. Sit down. I'm not McCracken's daughter. I'm not the person I give myself out to be. My name is Jane. This is my real hair. And that's all the truth you know about me. I came here to help McCracken with his project. That's why I wanted to get General Radlov a little bit interested in me, but it seems that you can't do things a little bit in Russia. Captain Mokin told me what happened at the school. He's superb, isn't he? Forgive me. Forgive me, André, please. I swear to you, it was not my fault. Please believe me. The general understood me as he wished to.
Do you believe me?
Yes.
Now comes the, well, the most important and the most difficult thing. Why were you so surprised when you saw me here? I came to give you an answer.
An answer to what?
It seemed to me that you proposed to me and asked me to give you an answer. Isn't that true?
Forgive me, please. I didn't know.
Did you propose to me?
Forgive me. I didn't understand how I was mistaken.
Oh, you're sorry for what you did. You regret it.
No, I regret how it happened, madam.
But what you said, was it the truth?
Yes. I suppose.
May I have some wine, please? You made me a proposal. André, men don't marry women like me. I'm not worth it, believe me. I'm not. What a beautiful music box. Why are you looking at me like that? I'm one of those women your mother must have warned you about. Is this your bed? Come here. Where are you? What's wrong? Huh? Don't you want to? Forgive me, please. I should go. Turn around. Disgusting. Please forgive me, André. Please forget everything. André! André! André, say something. Say something. I do. André. No.
Just.
Stop. Wait. Please. André. Listen to me.
I won't let you understand. Listen to me. Listen. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. I try to understand. I have never been. Please. No one has ever had any use for my heart or my heart. Please forgive me. Oh, my boy. Oh. I do.
Someone you don't know.
I took an oath to serve him.
Andre, do you love me?
Da.
In English.
Yes.
Yes, what? That's one word. It's three.
Russian tradition. I love you.
My beautiful, sweet boy.
I love you.
I've been waiting for you my whole life.
Feeling my stepfather provoked in women. You can call it love. It was more an animal passion, some kind of slavery. When I was about 14, my mother became very ill. I went to the hospital. I was very afraid to be alone in the house with my stepfather. I locked my bedroom door every night. But once he gave me a beautiful silk dress and invited me to an expensive restaurant, he kept pouring me a sweet wine, or who knows, maybe I asked for more myself. When we came home, I was very sleepy. I woke up from the pain. That was too late.
Jane.
No. No. I have to tell you everything. I've lied so much, I don't even remember anymore what's true and what's not true. But while with you, I know the truth, and I'm not afraid of it. What struck me most was when I woke up in the morning. I was lying with my arm around him.
He rented a room for me in a hotel. He told my mother he'd sent me to the summer camp. And he visited me almost every day. He brought me toys and candy.
What happened with your mother?
I saw her years later. After I'd escaped from him and the ugly life he made me lead. So he wouldn't have to work. He swore he'd kill me. He stole my clothes. And when I ran away, I had virtually nothing on but a nightshirt. My mother. I boarded a boat in Constantinople. I traveled third class, and I was watching the passengers on the upper deck, thinking how nice it must be to be among the first class passengers. And I saw my mother. She was still beautiful. She's in the company of elegantly dressed ladies and men, laughing, drinking champagne. And then she threw her empty glass into the sea. Why? Neither of us needed them.
So, you've never been married?
No.
Ваше благородие...
Стави! Какой подъем без четверти пять? Кто кричал?
Ваше благородие, видите
Стави,
ли...
Стави, все спать, быстро! Будет офицер Шаши!
Я!
Сейчас, Ай!
Слушай! А потому что не надо спать, когда друзья женятся. Извините, конечно. Опа!
Poco contante. Ed in vece del fandango, una marcia per il fango.
Отойдите, что вы делаете? Вы мне на проверку ступили. Вы себе яйца спалите. Сюзан.
Князь, довольный.
Но я в рай. Quei pennacchini, non piovrai, quel cappello, non piovrai, quella chioma, non piovrai, quell'aria brilla.
Давай, фарфороне аморозо.
Давай, муженек.
Графиня, на спину как рудин лохи, дайте посмотреть.
Ого!
No. If you stay here, you could ruin everything.
Правда понравилось, да?
Простите, мне нужно.
О, генерал!
Позвольте вам представить мисс Callahan.
Your Excellency, may I just say that it's a very great honor for me to meet you.
Ну что же, ваше императорское высочество, делаете?
Комарик.
Какие же комарики в апреле.
Царевич.
Беспардонно! Совсем беспардонно!
Укуси!
Как сказать брату? Строго?
Understand. I do.
Никого не пускать.
But, General, you promised to help us, and now it's a matter of honor.
Honor? You say this to me? Miss Callahan.
Yes.
I am smiling, but I suspect I know the truth.
What truth, Your Excellency? I'm astonished at your ridiculous behavior over a fan.
I'm ridiculous, Maria. You say this to me?
Yes. He's what, 20 years old? He's a boy in love, and you, how can you compare yourself to a little boy who did a silly thing with no basis for it?
But you didn't come home last night.
General, are you trying to insult me? Oh, no. You might as well be jealous of that child, your crown prince, Mikhalkov.
Ну, почему не переодеваетесь?
О, я переодеваюсь.
Юнкер, налейте мне сок.
Так что сказал? Что? А? Яйца спалите, Сюзанна! Господа, идемте курить!
Андрей! Listen to me, all right? Just, oh God, try to understand. This is what my life is. It's nobody's fault. It's André.
André! André!
Listen to me, you must believe me. You must. What I'm doing now is something else. It's business. It's business. All right? Without love and a naked, repulsive, foul pretense.
Thank you.
Андрей!
А что?
Вы... Ты... Толстой, что? Роту обосрать хочешь?
Я?
I love you. And only you. Explain everything after. All right, when the performance is over. I love you.
Держите.
Вы не видели Толстого?
А ну-ка, занимайтесь своим делом, полезайте в свою нору. Как великий князь в ложу уже.
Все, я готова.
Быстрее же!
Идем, давай! Голову, голову! Братик, побратик! Все, вперед!
Пациенты!
Of course.
A voi non tocca stare in pena per questo. Di chi si tratta?
Please don't be too hard on Tolstoi. I know he's gonna make you very proud in the future.
Al signor?
Споза мия. Графу понравилась моя невеста.
Графу понравилась моя невеста. Инди секретаменто рекуперар вория il diritto feudale possibile la cosa è naturale. Possible, natural.
For your sake, I forgive him.
naturalissima. E se Susanna vuol, possibilissima.
Finiscila una volta.
Стой, вы куда?
Толстой, стой! Андрей! Толстой, стой! Андрей! Толстой!
Андрей!
Тихо, Андрей, тихо, спокойно!
I can't sleep. You know? I'm going crazy. You hate? Come on! What is so important to you about this Mozart?
Like I told you, sir, he's a great composer.
Yeah. But what do you care? Where are you going?
Come on.
What are you doing? Where are you going now?
Follow me.
Listen, wait up.
How fickle our happiness can be. How blind and naive we are when we think ourselves masters of our own lives and talents. A human being is a vessel waiting to be filled. To not understand that is a sad delusion, one which Jane had been living under for many years. She was truly in love for the first time in her life. She was convinced it would be forever. And she believed she had explained everything fully to André. She was shocked by his behavior.
Newspapers say that Tolstoi made an assassination attempt on the Grand Duke and that you threw yourself in front of him.
Well?
Well, it is a lie. And you know it. And it's your duty to tell the truth.
What truth, madam?
The whole truth.
Do you want me to tell everyone how you humiliated me? Insulted my feelings. How this boy, out of jealousy, whipped me.
Mrs. General in public with a ball. Miss McCracken, I may look like an idiot.
If you want the whole truth, I will also have to speak of how you seduced and ruined this boy.
I?
Yes, yes, my dear. You've ruined him. But he's a Russian officer. He'll never speak about it. He'd rather die a convict.
But Your Excellency...
Your High Excellency. The Grand Duke promised your father his money. Signed your papers and my promotion.
Can it be true that human life means nothing in this country?
It depends whose life, madam.
You'd be better off drinking, Your High Excellency.
Последние новости. Владельцы покушения на его высочество.
Иди сюда.
Последние здорово. Новости. Владельцы покушения.
Ну-ка. Сюда. Сюда иди.
Юнкер признался сюда в покушении давай. На великого князя. Это конец. Иди сюда. Дайте. Запивай. Получи.
Добрый день.
Здравствуйте.
Do you speak English?
Yes.
Oh, good. You have a prisoner here by the name of Tolstoi.
Which Tolstoi?
Andrei.
A relative of the writer?
No.
Are you his sister?
No.
His wife?
No.
Who are you to him? Who are you to him?
Well,
You have permission to see him?
No, but I can pay anything you want.
I'm sorry.
You don't know who I am, but I have to tell you that all lies, what's written in the newspapers, is just not true. I saw it all. I was there. Please, you're his mother, and if you wrote to the Tsar, then he would do something. I know that Andre loves him so much, and he believes in him.
Where are you?
I'm no one. Forgive me. Oh. I can't believe what a no one I am. Please write to the Tsar. Andre's trial was quick and behind closed doors. Radlov was right. Andrei pleaded guilty to the assassination attempt on the Grand Duke and never revealed the true reason behind his behavior. Soon after the trial, McCracken was granted the money to build his machine. But the price of the contract that had brought Jane to Russia turned out to be too high. The simple and merciless conclusion of events planted a feeling in her soul she had never recognized before, a feeling of guilt. I don't understand anything in this country.
Hello!
не узнаете? А двор тот, помните? Вы меня целились в упор. У меня пистолет запутался, а я бы вас убила. Пистолет в кармане запутался. А вас за что? Не за это ли?
А ну не спи!
Please, tell Jane.
Tolstoi, yes, okay.
At the station.
Look.
She has to come now.
Come to the party.
I can, sir.
I want you to chase her on my special ride.
She has to
come. Hey, don't close the door. I'm expecting more guests.
Pass on.
Polyevsky?
Yes, that's him.
When?
He said that Tolstoi had been sent away and that you should go to the railroad station to meet him.
Thank you.
Andrei was sentenced to 7 years of hard labor, followed by 5 years exile in Siberia. Jane tried to catch up with him. She wanted to explain everything and to say goodbye, but she was refused permission to travel across Russia. Then her life changed. She married McCraken and went back with him to America. Consumed with guilt, Jane continued searching for Andrei, but all of her letters to Russia went unanswered. It took McCracken 7 years to build his machine, and Jane another 3 to obtain permission to test it in Siberia. McCracken was happy. He didn't question Jane's motivations. She'd agreed to become his wife and help him only because she had no other way of getting to Siberia. Jane had discovered with great difficulty that Andrei had been exiled to the settlement of Ovsyanka, a designated area for ex-convicts near the camp. It took all of her energy to ensure that the machine was tested nearby.
Ovsyanka.
And I present you the Barber of Siberia! All right, here we go. Entry claw forward.
Jane could barely restrain herself from rushing to the carriage. She was separated from Andre by 2 miles of dirt road and by 10 years of waiting for this moment. 10 years through which Jane continued to love Andre and to feel guilty for what had happened. But there was another reason she wanted to see him. The secret she had kept all along.
André? André? Andre? Thank you.
Anybody here? It was a disaster. Jane understood that she was too late. Twenty minutes in Andre's house erased everything. All 10 years of waiting for this moment. Jane left Siberia, leaving behind McCracken and his machine. Without seeing André, without telling him why she'd come. Jane was riding down a dusty Siberian road without knowing where she was going or why she was doing it. She only knew that all she had left belonging to her alone was her secret. The secret that had tied her to that huge country, which remained, for her, a mystery. She has been keeping her secret for 20 years. The time has come to disclose it to you.
I'm gonna give you one last chance to get that mask off. Now say it! I don't give a shit about Mozart.
No, sir.
You gonna wear it for the rest of your life?
I have to.
For a songwriter?
Not a songwriter. Mozart is a great composer, sir. You heard his music. It's beautiful.
Oh, sort of nice.
Sort of nice?
Oh, he's a great composer.
What?
You win. Mozart is a great composer. Now will you take that mask off?
I can't hear you, sir.
What?
I can't hear you, sir.
Mozart is a great composer.
I can't hear you, sir.
Wait a minute. Mozart is a great composer.
I still can't hear you, sir.
Well, can't everybody hear me?
Hey, look, it's a sarge. What's he doing?
Mozart, who has busted my ass with a sledgehammer. Mozart, whose mother, father, sisters, brothers, cousins, aunts, and uncles can all get Mozart is a great composer! Oh!
Are you all right?
Oh, yes, ma'am. I'm just training my men in semaphore, ma'am. Excuse me. Go back to the camp! Now, can I help you, ma'am?
Well, I'm looking for a cadet McCracken.
Oh, no, not McCracken again. Cadet McCracken is being punished. He's got to run 2 more miles. Well, you could meet him back at the camp. I could show you the way if you like.
Sure.
What's that? I mean, who's that?
That is his father.
Yeah. That's a Russian uniform. Is he Russian?
Yes.
Oh. Well, that explains a lot. And Mozart is Russian, too.
No. Do you like Mozart?
Like him? I love him. Everybody loves Mozart. Mozart is a great composer. Oh,